Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I want to talk about an Irish legend that accompanies me for a long time now. The legend of Tiern an Oak, the land of eternal youth, a land full of beauty and of bliss. But before you try to find a land like this now, please also listen to the dangers it holds. Let me tell you of the story of Oisín and Niamh in Tiern an Oak. Oisín was the son of the legendary Fionn, the leader of the Fianna. Oisín was known as a poet and a bard, but also as a skilled warrior. He was also known for his strong sense of justice, and was well respected and highly valued among the Fianna. Oisín, Fionn and the Fianna had many adventures together, and it seemed like nothing would ever change, until that one fateful day. The Fianna came from just another great battle, and decided to rest at the beautiful and quiet shore of Loch Lane, near Killarney in the County Kerry. The heads were weary of the thoughts of the friends they had lost, and the faces they would never see again. Suddenly, as the men looked towards the water, a young maiden appeared, riding swiftly above the water on a beautiful white stallion. The Fianna couldn't believe what they saw. As the woman approached, every man turned to watch her beauty. Her long golden hair fell softly upon her shoulders. Her eyes were blue like the ocean, and her clothes were of the finest silk the Fianna had ever seen. Gold and silver patterns had been woven into them, a sight that was only surpassed by the crown on her head. But it wasn't just the maiden that stole the breath of the Fianna. Even the majestic horse she rode wore a silver crown and had golden braidings all over its body. She rode towards the men, and as she reached them, she spoke with a voice so gentle and kind. Her accent seemed strange and very, very old to the Fianna, who had never heard an accent like that. The maiden introduced herself as Niamh Cin Eoir, Niamh of the Golden Hair, Princess of Tiern an Oak. She told the Fianna that she was indeed the daughter of Manana MacLear, the King of the Oceans. Fionn, who was as captured by the woman as his man, spoke up and asked what she wanted. Niamh looked around the man for a second, and responded that she had heard of the bravery and the talents of the Fianna, and that she had come to seek a husband. Bewitched by the beauty of Niamh, all men instantly tried to show off in the hope that her choice would fall on them. Some showed their strength, others their talents with the sword. Only Oisín took the time to get his harp and tune it. He then started to play the most beautiful song directly from his heart. And not only did he get the attention of the Fianna, but as soon as the song came to Niamh's ears, she started to sing from her heart. And as both tunes met and melted into one, Niamh and Oisín knew they were meant to be together. Once more, Niamh spoke to Fionn. She had already heard of the pure heart, the beauty, the bravery and the skills of poetry and music that Oisín possessed. And she indeed came to ask for his hand. Fionn's heart was troubled, for he knew Niamh was one of the Sidhe, the people of the Otherworld. But he also knew that Oisín's mother was also one of the kind, and that it might be Oisín's fate to follow her to her people. One look at Oisín told Fionn that the lad would follow this woman no matter what he thinks about it. As Oisín heard her words, he was full of joy, ran to her and took her hands into his own. Niamh told him of the land she was from, a land where he would never know sorrow, nor death, nor age. A land where all he could wish for would come true. Where there were feasts and drinking, music and more riches than he could ever imagine. And where he would stay young and strong forever. Tempted by her words and her beauty, Oisín mounted the horse and was about to ride up with her, when Fionn called his name. He said, "You don't know what waits for you in this mysterious land. No one has ever returned." But Niamh just whispered into his ear, "Come away with me, Oisín. Come away to Tiernan an Oak, the most beautiful land you can imagine. We have no illness, no aging, no death, but beautiful valleys, tall mountains, and silver rivers." Oisín bid Fionn and the Fianna farewell, and promised to return one day, and a promise made by one of the Fianna must always be kept. Even though Fionn felt like this day will never come, he let him go and watched as Niamh and Oisín galloped away upon the water. Oisín was full of joy, and so he and Niamh rode past many strange places, beautiful palaces and cities, and finally they reached Yonder. Oisín looked around. This place was all that Niamh had promised, and more. He looked at the flawless blue skies, at animals without compare, at the beautiful people who seemed to be as happy as can be, and the jewels and gold that were to be found everywhere. Niamh and Oisín married. Oisín feasted on food and wine, composed a lot of poetry, and hunted every day. And so they lived very happy for a while. The happy couple had three children, a daughter and two sons, and it seemed like everything was perfect. But after a while, that felt like an eternity, Oisín felt the call back to Ireland, for he desired to see his father and the Fianna again. For a while, Niamh was able to distract his thoughts through more feasts, hunts, or other entertainment. But after a while, he couldn't ignore the aches in his heart anymore. And so, after 3 years, he asked Niamh if he could visit Ireland once more. And Niamh's heart sank. She knew that time passes slowly in Tiernan Oak, and that the land he wanted to return to wouldn't exist anymore. She feared to lose him, but couldn't refuse to let him go. So she called upon her white horse and made him promise that whatever happens, he may never, under no circumstances, set a foot on Irish soil, or he would never be able to return to her. Oisín didn't quite understand why, but gave her the promise to never set a foot on Irish soil, and to return to her and their children. And so he rode away, while Niamh had the feeling that she may never see her fair love again. Oisín, unaware of his fate, rode away with a light heart and full of joy to see his friends and family again. But as he arrived in Ireland, he couldn't find Fionn anywhere, and he was confused about the sights he saw. Mighty castles he once knew, that now lay in ruins and had been overgrown. The forest he and the Fianna loved to hunt in were chopped down, and the people he found seemed to have grown a lot smaller and weaker than the people he remembered. Not more than children in his eyes. And he came across a lot of churches, which he had never seen before. The thought that something must have happened while he was away grew stronger and stronger. After a while, he approached a man on the road and asked for the whereabouts of his father. But the man didn't know who Fionn was. Oisín couldn't believe him, since everyone knew Fionn and the Fianna, and he rode off. Once again after a while, he came across another group of men and asked about the Fianna again. Those men had indeed heard of Fionn, but only in very, very old legends and poems. Only now Oisín realized that while his time in the land of youth felt for him like 3 years, in Ireland, really 300 years had passed. He was devastated, his heart broke, and he was already about to return to his great love Niamh and his children, when he came across two other men, who were unable to lift the large boulder. He approached them and leaned over to lift the rock, for it was a small thing to the likes of him, and he lifted it without a problem, but as small as the boulder seemed to him, Its weight was enough so that the saddle strap snapped and he fell off his horse. The white stallion ran off in fright, never to be seen again. And Oisín, as soon as the skin touched the ground, was caught up by the years he had missed. The two men near him rushed to help him up, but found him not being the young, beautiful, strong man he was a minute ago, but an old man near to death, weeping for the family and friends he would never see again, and begging for someone to write down all the stories Oisín had to tell about the Fianna. The man brought him to the great Bishop Patrick, who is now known as Saint Patrick. Patrick helped him to be comfortable and listen to the stories Oisín told of Fionn and the Fianna. As Oisín ended, and Patrick had everything written down, both men started to argue at length. For Patrick came to Ireland to bring Christianity to the people, and Oisín still was an advocate for the old ways. Patrick wanted to baptize Oisín and to prepare him for his death and the afterlife. But Oisín denied Christianity, stood true to the way of his people, the path of honor, and in the end, died as the last of his kind. It is said that with his last thought of all he had lost, the one thing he regretted most of having lost was his wife Niamh. For if he could choose between 300 years with the Fianna, or one single day with his love, he would always choose Niamh. Some say that until this day, once in a while, a woman on a white horse can be seen, galloping above the water, in the hope of finding her true love again. And that was the story of Oisín and Niamh in Tírna an Óg. If you like this Irish story as much as I did, please subscribe and leave a like. And I see you next time. Bye!